is it. This is a night that we have all anticipated and have arduously worked for our entire lives, especially during these past 4 years. We entered high school with our eyes mostly on graduation. Yet, through our friendships, studies, and self-discovery, we have broadened our views more towards our futures. We discovered how to rely more on ourselves and have learned to appreciate our families and to hold them closely. We've grown up with friends we've had since elementary school and have even had the opportunity to make new friends from around the world. We cannot celebrate our successes alone, but with the people who have encouraged us through the years. My fellow graduates and I have set high goals and high standards and have not allowed unfortunate circumstance or challenge to prevent our successes. We have all had our own hurdles to overcome in getting to this graduation night and advancing to the next phase of our lives. But what matters most is that we have overcome our individual obstacles through determination and the grace of God to get the job done. My fellow graduates, as Ralph Waldo Emerson once said, remember what lies behind us and what lies before us are tiny matters compared to what lies within us. We are the generation that can now step up to responsibilities, take control of our own lives, and successfully lead our future families, communities, country, and world. In the words of Confucius, wherever you go, go with all of your heart. We are all meant to shine. Get it?
Got it!
Good.
Thank you. class of 2006. This may be it for our years at Bushing High School, but it is the beginning of our lives and long-lasting friendships. We have not only grown and matured over these 4 years, but we have also built character, values, and morals. We should not think of this gathering just as the graduation ceremony, but as the starting line to our own race. That's right, class of 2006, this is not the end. I know personally that it was sometimes dreadful walking through those front doors hearing Mr. Brown say, young man, young lady, or from some of us suffering from bad cases of senioritis, but we stuck to it and look at us now. There are some parents up there saying, thank you, Jesus, because unfortunately, there were doubts about some of us making it. We even doubted ourselves sometimes. But we sure proved everyone wrong. This graduation is just another step towards our own greatness. Now, let's talk about how we first started out at VHS. Remember roaming clueless through the halls wondering, does J-Ho have a pool? Is there really an elevator? Or laughing at our teachers as they performed at the Funkathon and competing with other classes as we represented 06. And what about lunch? That's something I could say we're all gonna miss the most. Especially the mac and cheese, the fried chicken, and collard greens. And we can't forget about those famous hot wings and how Chef Liz charged us our allowance just for some extras. I know, looking back on our memories is fun, but now it's time to think seriously. We are no longer children, and we have to choose our own destinies. Our parents are not going to be there to tell us when to get up or what to do today. Our teachers are not going to be there to tell us to make up this assignment. But we have to be our own alarm clocks to wake up and see that we have the power to make the right decision. And please note, just because we're graduating doesn't mean that our memories and friendships have to cease. Think of this graduation as our line of candles being blown out and our parade of torches being lit. This symbolizes our future. It is only brightening and prospering from here on. Before I go, I would like the class of 06 to stand up and thank the most important people that helped us get here, our family and friends.
Coming home.
change for the better. I do believe I have been changed for the better. And because I knew you, because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed.
This is what it feels like, to accomplish a great milestone, to prove to all who said you can't that we just did, to put a smile of pride on the faces of those who always had faith in us and always knew that we'd be in this position today. So this is what it feels like to graduate from Richland High School. We have been waiting for this moment all of our lives, but it took a great deal of strength to get here today. How do we get it? To get this, we had to take a long journey, a journey that we've been taking since we've been able to understand and will continue to take for the rest of our lives. We all have different experiences, but one thing that everyone graduating here today has in common is that we all had to fall. We all had to stumble and our knees to buckle to be in this position today. Alicia Keys once wrote something called Tears for Water. She wrote, "Everything I've ever written has stemmed from my tears of joy, of pain, of sorrow, of desperation, and of question. Every single word has come from some form of my tears. I use them as water to nourish me, quenching the thirst of understanding myself. And because of them, I am able to survive, I'm able to stay alive, I am able to breathe. We have and need to continue to use our tears for water. We is not just the senior class, we is every single human being in this stadium today."
Failing
is not the problem. The problem comes with how we handle our failures. We have to decide when we fall if we will stay down or if we will get back up. No one is perfect and we all have our flaws, but we cannot let that get us down. We have to use it to build ourselves up. We have to get back up stronger, ready to conquer the impossible. That is one of the reasons why we're here today. We have made it out of the fire. We have worked hard for so long, and now today, we will get our reward. We got it, but now what will we do with it? Many people can get things, but don't know what to do with it once they got it. As young adults entering into the big world, we need to do something with what we have.
And that does not include... We have worked so hard
to get this diploma that to not take advantage of it would be a foolish move.
The world
is ours for the taking. Grab it up. Don't get discouraged or overwhelmed because of difficulties. The worst thing to do is to turn away. We have to defeat our fears and overcome our obstacles. Move past it. This is it, BHS. Our time is now. We are entering into the real world, and excuses are no longer acceptable. It's easy to make excuses, but it takes a real man and woman to own up to their actions or lack thereof and use it to succeed.
Rise
above the odds and prove to everyone, especially yourself, that you can do it,
You have done it. We all have done it. And this is not the end. We have to let everyone know who we are and that we mean business. We are the class of 2006. Get it? Got it? Yeah. Because this is not the end. This is not the end. This is not the last you will hear from us. We're out of the school and pursuing new goals and dreams, whether anyone else likes it or not. We are the class of 2006. We will make a difference. We will succeed. Thank you, and God bless.
Relatives and friends. We welcome you to our graduation ceremonies for Richland High School's class of 2006. This evening, I am honored to present to you those students who have fulfilled the requirements for graduation that have been established by our school district and the state of New Jersey. Will the officers for the class of 2006 please stand to be recognized as I call your names? President Chloe Williams. Vice President Chelsea Adams. Secretary Dana Dolbo. Treasurer Diana Carrasco. And historian Claire Gossigan. The valedictorian for the class of 2006 is Ms. Claire Casaboon. Please stand. And the co-salutatorians are Kristen Swanson and Alvin G. Richards. We would now like to recognize those students who are graduating with specific honor status as designated by the cords that they are wearing. We would ask that those students stand when recognized and remain standing. The audience should note that our distinguished scholars are recognized by the white cord. Our meritorious scholars are recognized by the maroon cord. Honor Society members are wearing the gold cord. Students wearing blue cords are recipients of merit awards. Our exchange student is wearing a red cord. And those students wearing silver cords are graduates of the adult high school. It is with great honor that I present these students seated before you to be graduated from Bridgeland High School. On another warm evening in June, I participated in graduation ceremonies for my first class of students, the class of 2002, and I was feeling on top of the world. Tonight, the feeling is a little different, you see. I've worked with these students since they first entered Bridgeland High School as ninth graders, and I'm as proud as any of you parents and guardians in the audience. Let's give these young people another round of applause. On the other hand, there have also been times when I too have wanted to pull my hair out over their antics. As you can see, I still have my hair, but it's just a little grayer around the edges. Thank you. So, for all that we have done for you, the class of 2006, I believe a round of applause is in our honor is warranted. Victor Hugo once said, "There is nothing like a dream to create the future." I believe that as children and young adults, our experiences and our dreams play a vital role in shaping our futures. We envision who we are and who we want to be, where we want to go, and what we want to do. It's the how we get there that usually causes the most concern. Through endless hours of daydreaming, we nurture, revise, and expand our plan. For many of us, the plan is rather simple. We seem to know instinctively where our future lies. We follow family tradition, or we recognize our own unique talents and skills, and are automatically drawn to careers that promote our areas of interest. For the rest of us, the roadmap is much, much more difficult. There are lots of twists and turns, setbacks and drawbacks, stop signs and construction sites. Every so often, we might even have to stop in the middle of the road, make a U-turn, go back a few blocks, and start all over again. These young people gathered here tonight have also dreamed those dreams. Their participation in the ceremony this evening confirms the fact that they too realize that education is the first step to a successful economic future in this ever-growing global society. They recognize that receiving a high school diploma is just the first step in fulfilling their dreams. They continue to revise the plan, and they continue to dream. When I reflect on what has made this class unique from any other to graduate from Bridgeland High School, and significantly different from my first class of students, it is that they are a group of dreamers. They are optimistic and in some cases adamant that they will succeed in their endeavors. Over the years, I have had the unique opportunity to have had an ongoing dialogue with many of these young people. I have listened to their hopes and plans for the future, and I am proud to announce that you are looking at the next generation of community leaders, teachers, doctors, nurses, engineers, auto mechanics, graphic artists, computer programmers, and military officers. Finally, as Mark Twain once said, 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things that you didn't do than by the ones you did. So throw off the bow lines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, discover. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the class of 2006. Next guest, I would like to remind everyone seated in the audience to remain seated for the recessional. The seniors will return to the high school to pick up their diplomas. Parents, you can meet them over in front of the lobby area. We also ask that you do not come out onto the track. I would now like to present our mayor, Michael Paroli, and councilman, Mr. Douglas Van Sant, who will make special presentations to the valedictorian and co-salutatorians.
Thank you. We have a special privilege and a pleasure in giving official city recognition to those students who have earned the highest grades in their class. Ms. Kosovan, please come forward. Now you know, the position of a valedictorian is really a special one. This is the person who has the highest grades in her class in this whole school system. This carries with it, of course, a great responsibility. We all expect great things of you. Nonetheless, we don't send you out there all alone. We send you out there with our great blessing and our goodwill. And I think our promise that if there's anything we can do for you, we'll do it. But it's a privilege on the part of the city to give special recognition to this effort. And so, council passed a resolution, which I'll read to you, whereas Claire Elizabeth Kosovan has brought honor to her family, to her school and community, upon being designated valedictorian of 2006 graduating class of Bridgeton High School. And whereas Claire Elizabeth Kosovan has received many honors, including Academic Excellence Award, National Youth Leadership Nominee, Sir Optimist Student of the Month, New Jersey Girls State Candidate Nominee, and whereas Claire Elizabeth Kosovan participated in various class activities, including marching band, choir, musical productions, National Honor Society, the Baconian, as well as field hockey and softball. Now, therefore, be it resolved by myself and City Council of this city that Claire Elizabeth Kosovan be accorded the congratulations of her community through this expression of great pride in her accomplishments, with hope that she will realize happiness, fulfillment, and the best of everything life has to offer. This was adopted at a regular meeting of the council on June 5. Good luck.
Good evening. As you may or may not know, I don't know if this ever happened before, but we had a tie for a salutatorian this year. So I've asked fellow councilman Mike Lopez to give the, I can't say second, but the second part of the tie. At this time, I would like to ask Kristen Swanson to come forward, please. Again, we have adopted a resolution at a regular meeting on June 5th of this year. And it's a resolution of the City of Bridgeton honoring Kristen Swanson. Whereas Kristen Swanson has brought honor to her family, school, and community upon being named salutatorian of the Bridgeton High School class of 2006. And whereas Kristen Swanson has earned distinction being a member of the student government, the ECHO, Honor Society member, and Leo's Club. And whereas Kristen Swanson has received honors including Academic Excellence Award and the Brotherhood and Sisterhood Essay Contest. Now, therefore, let it be resolved by the Mayor and City Council of the City of Bridgeton that Kristen Swanson be commended on achieving the distinction of salutatorian, and may her future be filled with the best of everything life has to offer. Congratulations.
I've had the pleasure to watch many of these students enter the ninth grade, grow, develop, and prepare themselves to take on the next step in life. So every graduation to me is quite an honor. I have the honor to present to the other or co-salutatorian, Alvin Richard III. Would you come forth? I have to say that this young man is well-rounded. I love you and bye-bye, Birdie. I loved your dancing, your singing, your acting. Well-rounded. Many attributes, and this is why the resolution of the City Council of the City of Bridgeton is honoring you today with this resolution. Whereas Alvin Richards III has brought honor to his family, school, and community upon being named salutatorian of the Bridgeton High School class of 2006, and whereas Alvin Richards III has earned distinction being a member of the student government, HOSA, select choir, the Honor Society, as well as playing baseball, bowling, and basketball. And whereas Alvin Richards III has received honors, including All-State Choir, All-South Jersey Choir, Honors Band. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Mayor and City Council of the City of Bridgeton that Alvin Richards III be commended on achieving the distinction of salutatorian, and may his future be filled with the best of everything life has to offer. And this is adopted June 5th, 2006. Congratulations.
At this time, I'd like to introduce our Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Victor Gilson.
Good evening. This is a time when all of you in the stands are very, very happy. I can tell from the applause. I can also tell you that it's a great feeling to sit out here, having been a 1970 graduate of Bridgeton High School. And I said to the students today that while the years have gone by since 1970, I can actually remember it like it was yesterday. I'm sure many of you in the audience here tonight have had that same experience. And one thing I would ask all of you is that when these students, these graduates, have their name called, I'd like you to remember that those of you seated up there gave them their names, and that it's important that all of you have an opportunity to hear your loved one's name. And so when you clap and when you cheer, I know, we know, it's a feeling of love. That's all in the 12 years that I've served these youngsters since they were in first grade. The only thing I've asked of you is to love your children. It costs no money. It costs nothing but effort, dignity, and maturity. And I said that to these graduates today. It's very important that you love them and that you respect each and every one of them up here as if they were your own tonight as they receive their diplomas. That's my simple request of you here tonight. Now, it's my pleasure to introduce some important folks here this evening that have helped serve your children and your loved ones. Those children did not get here without the help of custodians, teachers, bus drivers, everyone who has served them in the Bridgeton Public Schools. Sometimes those people are forgotten. I can tell you that there was a time during their perhaps 13 or even 14 years in this school system that you needed them and they were there for you. But also, we have elected officials here that help us provide this evening. Seated here tonight, we have some board members. I'd just like to briefly mention them. Mr. Kenny Smith-Bay. Thank you, Kenny. Mr. Jonathan Griffin. Mr. Jerry Branch. Ms. Brenda Delacroix. Ms. Marie Bernstein. And Mr. Curtis Edwards. Thank you very much. They give their time and effort, and the only reward they get is this evening and your appreciation. This evening is also made possible because I have someone who helps me every single day, the Assistant Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Patricia Felton Montgomery. You've been a great audience. I love you for it. Now, with all the power vested in me by the New Jersey State Board of Education, the Bridgeton Board of Education, the State Department of Education, I certify this evening to you that these graduates have satisfied all the requirements needed in order to graduate from Bridgeton High School and I further certify they can now be called alumni of Brixton High School. At this time, it is also my honor and my pleasure to bring to the podium the president. At this time to bring to the podium the president of the Brixton Board of Education, Mr. Jack Sorensi.
Brixton Board of Education, I'd like to present this diploma to Chloe Williams. We accept the diploma for the class of 2006.
As president, it's an honor for me to accept this diploma for the class of 2006. Omar Bravo, Satoya T. Conaway. Abigail Garcia. Juanita M. Scurry.
Marco Prisciliano. Katie M. Sears. William Charles Ramsey.
Angelique LeSharon Seegers.
Yeah.
secretary for the class of 2006, Dana M. Dalbo.
Vice president for the class of 2006, Chelsea